Thomas the Tank Engine is very proud of his branch line. Ever since the day he earned it after rescuing James from his accident, he's been running the line with his trusty friends on rain nor shine. One morning, Thomas puffed into dry-off station. A cold winter breeze swept onto his boiler as he slowed to a stop.
It's always so cold in the mornings. I don't even think my boiler can keep me warm.
If only we were fitted with radiators.
That would be the best Christmas present ever.
Morning, Thomas.
Morning, Percy. Going to Knapford Harbour?
Yeah, I am. I have to wait for Harold to bring some important parcels from the mainland, though, which is why I'm here a bit earlier than usual.
We'll be carrying lots of parcels soon.
True. My trains generally get heavier during winter, and it's hard work at times.
Heavy? Passenger trains aren't hard work. I should know. I sometimes pull your trains when you're unavailable.
Pfft. Nonsense. True, you do at times, but you never pulled my trains full-time, remember?
I did when you were away at the National Railway Museum a few years ago. In fact, I did so well with your trains, I'm surprised the Fat Controller didn't let you stay in York and let me have the passenger trains all to myself.
You never pulled my trains in winter. And believe me, the hills can be extremely difficult to climb. It's not easy work. But you would know all about easy work, now don't you?
What's that supposed to mean?
Oh, you know, shunting, hauling trucks. I could do that in my sleep, and be on time as well.
Thomas, that's enough!
They're right.
Thank you.
Let's settle this in a different way.
Wait, that's not what we meant.
How about... we swap jobs tomorrow. You take my goods trains, and I'll take your passenger trains.
Alright, I accept. Now we'll truly see who has the toughest work in winter.
Good morning, everyone. Here's the important parcels, Percy. Make sure they arrive on time.
They won't be late when I'm pulling the mail tomorrow, Harold!
Very funny. I'll soon have the last laugh.
Sunday morning broke, and another cold breeze swept all over Soda. The engine fires were lit and they were simmering nicely, ready for another day's work. Thomas and Percy were chattering to each other in the sheds. They hushed quietly as the crew approached. You're in luck, you two. I contacted the Fat Controller about the change, and he said he's okay about you two swapping jobs for today.
What's going on? You two swapping jobs? Why?
We want to see who has the hardest work in this kind of weather. Percy insisted that the passenger runs were no problem to him.
They are. Of course it'll be Thomas with the heavy loads, right, Toby?
Now I see what's going on. Well, best of luck to you both.
Thanks, Toby!
I don't need luck. Just wait and see.
Very shortly, everyone on the branch line was hard at work. Thomas us whooshed into the harbour with a train of heavy stone trucks.
My, this place has changed. The last time I was here was when I collected Trevor the traction engine from Edward and brought him here with some metal pilings.
And don't forget the Vicar's Sunday school runs. It's a pity the station over there only services goods these days.
Yeah, I miss those runs. Oh, how I love a bit of sea breeze sweeping through the cab.
Never mind the sea breeze, just stoke the fire.
Thomas shunted the stone trucks away into the sidings, then bustled over to the station to collect a train of goods for Farquhar. Meanwhile, Percy was puffing through the countryside with Annie and Clarabel. In the distance, he could see Thomas waiting at the signal with his goods train.
Good luck climbing that hill!
I don't need luck!
Percy continued on. Soon, he approached a very steep hill. As he began to climb, Thomas's earlier predictions began to prove correct. Percy's wheels began to slip, and he felt the weight of the coaches straining on the coupling.
Come on, Percy, you can do it. Double faster, Simon, faster!
Percy pounded his pistons, but it was no good. The icy rails and the heavy coaches began to pull him backwards down the hill.
Oh no! Help!
Brakes, car, please!
Weary with defeat, Percy slipped back down to the bottom of the hill. He felt sad.
Oh dear. I'm sorry.
Minor setback, Percy. Don't worry. We just gotta put some sand on the rails to get a better grip.
It's not the first time this sort of thing has happened, Percy.
Percy felt better, but now, sighing with embarrassment, he now knew that Thomas had been right all along about the hills. Percy's driver and fireman quickly spread sand on the rails and scrambled back into the cab, and they reversed to give Percy a head start. And this time, whistling loudly, Percy charged up the hill.
I might have been wrong, but I'll show Thomas I can climb this hill.
Coupling tightened, and his wheels spun faster and faster. For a second, Percy felt his wheels spinning in one place again.
Not again. No way. We've done it. Well done, Percy. Well done.
Percy was exhausted, but he felt so relieved. He continued on to Ellsbridge, and he had no more troubles with hills for the rest of the day.